In this exercise, we will create surface geometries with algorithmic properties using Rhino and Grasshopper, and then we'll transform these to ArchiCAD slabs. Let's start by creating surfaces using a new Rhino project from scratch. Open Rhinoceros 64-bit version by double-clicking its icon on the desktop. Display the new panel on the startup dialog. Select the large object meter template from the list. In the Rhino toolbar, select Curve Tools. Choose the Control Point Curve option from the Curve Tool icon toggle on the left side. Draw two curves using the top view as shown on the screen. Select the lower curve and type Move in the command line. Move the curve upwards by a minimum of 30 meters using the front view. Estimate this distance by watching the grid in the front view. You may further align and move the created curves in perspective view. We will use the two curves to create a loft surface. Type Loft in the command line. Select the two curves to define the loft. Display the Loft Options dialog and select the Normal Style option, yet notice that other styles are also available. The created surface should look similar to the one shown on the screen. Repeat the previous step to create a second surface. These surfaces will define the external envelope of a high-rise building. Start by creating two curves in the top view using the Control Point Curve option. Move one of the curves in the front view by typing Move into the command line. Continue by typing Loft into the command line. Select the two curves and create a surface as shown on the screen. Display the right view and adjust the distance between the surfaces. Check out the results in the perspective view. Press the Control or Command keys and the left arrow key to organize the Rhino application window to the left. Type Grasshopper into the command line to open Grasshopper. Organize the Grasshopper application window to the right. We will place two Grasshopper surface components to reference the surfaces created in Rhino. Display the parameters page in Grasshopper. Drag and drop the surface component to the canvas. You may also start typing surface on the canvas for the same result. Place another surface component on the Grasshopper canvas. When both surfaces are placed, right-click on each surface component and choose Set One Surface from the menu. Select the corresponding Rhino surfaces one by one as shown on the screen. To divide up the surfaces by elevation contours, a Grasshopper contour component is required. Begin typing contour on the canvas and select the contour parameter from the list. The contour parameter has various input nodes. Connect the node of the surface component with the shape node of the contour parameter. Duplicate the contour parameter and place the second instance next to the second shape component. Connect the same nodes as before. To define the distance for the contours, you must input a direction and a distance. For the surfaces to be divided up vertically, a unit Z factor and a number slider is required to define the distance. Type unit Z to place a vector. Connect its node with the direction node of the contour parameter. Do the same with the upper contour parameter as well. Type a desired number, 5 in this example, into the canvas search box that appears instantly as you begin to type. Connect the number slider with the distance node of the contour parameter. Create the same connection with the other contour parameter as well. Once the values are defined by the slider, the contours appear on the surfaces in Rhino. Click on the contour parameters and notice that the contour lines are highlighted with green on the previously created surface in Rhino. To define lofts by the corresponding curves on the surfaces, type loft into the canvas search box. Use the Shift command to create connections with both contour nodes and the input node of the loft parameter. Notice that now the loft shape appears in Rhino. It can happen that the U and V directions of the surfaces are not aligned, in which case the loft will look twisted. To solve this issue, the surface dimensions must be shifted on the original Rhino surfaces. Type DIR into the command line in Rhino and then press Enter. Select the surface from the Appearing Selection menu and press Enter. Rhino prompts you to choose U, V, or both directions. Choose the V direction as displayed. Observe the little white arrows showing the V direction of the surface. Click on one of the right arrows to shift the direction. Notice that now the arrows are pointing towards the opposite direction. The loft is now aligned properly. The Grasshopper loft is compatible with the ArchiCAD slab component. Type slab into the canvas search box or display the ArchiCAD tab in Grasshopper and choose the slab component to place it. Connect the loft node with the curve node of the slab component. The slab component will be displayed in red to signal that there's a problem to solve. Click on the slab component to find out more about this. The problem is that the Grasshopper ArchiCAD connection is not active. The connection between ArchiCAD and Grasshopper not found, restart the connection in ArchiCAD. To resolve this, first open ArchiCAD by double-clicking its icon on the desktop. Select the Open a Project option, browse for a solo project, select and open the actemplate1.pln file. Click the Skip Library Migration if the Migration Assistant dialog is displayed. Position the ArchiCAD application window to the right side of the screen. Select the Grasshopper connection option from the Design, Design Extras menu to display the Grasshopper dialog. Click the Start Connection button to start the Grasshopper ArchiCAD Live connection. Open the 3D window of ArchiCAD and notice that the slabs are already displayed here. This ArchiCAD template file includes schedules. Display the navigator and double-click to open the One Slabs schedule. Observe the total gross volume of the slabs. This is very useful information at the beginning of a design process. Please notice that the boundary surfaces of the building were not yet displayed in ArchiCAD because those were not converted to ArchiCAD elements. Surfaces with double curvature are not directly convertible to curtain walls in ArchiCAD, but they can be converted to morphs. The ArchiCAD morph component will take the Grasshopper mesh for input, so we'll convert the surface to mesh. Let's add a mesh component to the canvas. Type mesh as the search keyword, and then select the mesh brep from the list. Place two of the mesh brep parameters on the canvas. Connect the brep nodes with the Grasshopper surface components. The mesh can now be fed to the ArchiCAD morph. Either type morph on the canvas search box, or select the morph component on the ArchiCAD tab in Grasshopper. Connect the mesh nodes. Repeat these steps for the other surface as well. Switch to ArchiCAD and notice that the boundary surfaces are now visible there. To demonstrate how quick and easy it is to change the design in Grasshopper, Let's change the distance of the floor slabs. Return to Grasshopper. Notice that the number currently displays only integers. Double-click the number slider connected to the contour parameters at the beginning of the algorithm to open their settings dialog. You can click on the letter R to change from integers to numbers with decimals. You can now adjust the number of digits by adjusting the digit slider. This way, you can define more precise distances between the slabs. Adjust the floor height below 4 meters. Switch to ArchiCAD and notice that the 3D window already displays the model with the updated floor height. Navigate to the slab schedule again in ArchiCAD. By creating a lower floor-to-floor height, the slab volume and surface area have become significantly larger. This might be a real-life scenario where similar requirements are given during the design process.